What's up, game developers? CouchFerret here, and today we'll modify our walls by adding collider and rigidbody components to them so our archer won't be able to run through them. We'll upgrade the movement script as well to a physics-based one with velocity. If it sounds fun, then stay with me and consider subscribing with the bell icon so you won't miss any future videos of this game. Cool, let's begin! Okay, let's make the walls into real and tough walls so our archer can't move through them. We will make this happen by making our game objects into physical objects with collider and rigidbody components. Collider components like box collider, circle collider, or polygon collider define the game object's shape for Unity's physics simulation. And rigidbody components define an object's physical behavior. For example, our walls will be tough and unmovable, whereas our archer will be a light object that we could push around if we want. The first step is to select one of the horizontal wall game objects under the grid game object and add a box collider 2D component to it. There are separate colliders for 2D and 3D games, so make sure to use the ones that have a 2D in their names this time. Let's set the collider size to 0.2 by 0.04, so it takes up 2 cells in our grid. We need to set the Y offset to 0.02 to have it fit perfectly. To make it behave as a physics object, we need to add a rigidbody 2D component to it. By default, it will be a dynamic object that can be pushed around, but we want our walls stiff. So let's set its body type to kinematic, so gravity and other physics objects can't move or apply force to this object. To change all existing and future horizontal wall objects in our scene, we need to click the Apply button at the top of the inspector window, and it will save these changes to the horizontal wall prefab. And by changing the prefab, we are changing all the horizontal wall objects. Now, if I click on another horizontal wall instance, we can see that it has the components that we've just added. Let's add the same components to the vertical walls too. But their colliders will have a bit different shape and offset. The size should be 0.06 by 0.08 and the offset should be 0.04 on the y-axis. The rigidbody components settings should be the same. Let's hit apply and we are done with it. To give the pillars a bit rounded shape, we will make them a collider which is similar to a box collider, but we will round its edges off a bit. We can do this by using a polygon collider 2D. It's a collider type where we can set all the individual points to create a custom shape. Let's align the points roughly. You can create new points by clicking and dragging the edges, and you can delete one by clicking on it by holding down the Ctrl key. After aligning them, we can set the individual points' coordinates in the inspector window so they will be precise. Just round the values. And let's add a rigid body component as well with a kinematic body type. Also, don't forget to hit apply in the end. Okay, we are almost done. We only need to give the archer character a collider and a rigid body. Let's select the archer and add a circle collider to him. The radius should be around 0.04 and let's offset it a bit to 0.005 and minus 0.095. Give him a rigid body, set the gravity scale to 0, and we are ready to give it a test. He's a bit jumpy, but it's working. This jumpiness comes from our non-physics-based movement script. By changing his transform.position explicitly and out of the physics engine, it makes our character go into the wall, but when a physics evaluation happens, the engine will push him back from the wall. If we move him through his rigid body component's velocity parameter, then the physics engine will take care of setting his position counting the walls in front of him. To achieve this, first we need to create a public variable to access his rigid body. Let's call it RB, save the script, and drag and drop the rigid body 2D component into this new parameter. Then, let's set its velocity based on the movement vector. A rigidbody 2D's velocity parameter is only 2D, so we need to create a new vector 2 here and use only the x and y components of the movement vector. We don't need a time that delta time multiplier because we are not explicitly setting the archer's position, only its current moving direction. The physics engine will calculate his new position and the simulation will take account of the elapsed time. We can call this move function both in the update or fixed update function because it has no immediate effect, but calling it in the update function will make our game slightly more responsive because the inputs are updated during every frame. Let's test it out. He started to spin like crazy when he ran into the wall. We need to set him a rotation constraint to freeze his rotation. Let's select him and under its rigid body constraints, check freeze rotation Z. Now it looks okay. Our character doesn't bounce back from the walls, but sometimes he gets stuck in the middle of the wall. Seems like there are phantom vertexes. If we take a closer look in the scene window, we can see that our walls are made of a few colliders next to each other. And where two colliders meet, no matter how well we align them, a phantom vertex could appear, which makes our character get stuck or bounces off it. We could merge these colliders together with a composite collider component. A composite collider merges all of the colliders which are set to be used by a composite collider and are on child objects of the object having the composite collider. Let's add a composite collider to the grid game object. Unity will also add a rigidbody 2D component to it too, so make sure to set the body type to kinematic. Now, we need to change all the wall game objects' colliders. Check in the colliders used by composite parameter, and we need to remove the rigidbody 2D components, because we will use the grid object's rigidbody. Hit apply to save the changes, and select the grid game object so we can see how it merged the colliders together. It looks pretty solid, except for a few holes here and there where I forgot to put vertical walls. Let's try it out. Oh, it's so smooth! Let's fill in those holes. We need to duplicate a few vertical walls and move them to the correct place. Sometimes the composite collider doesn't merge the neighbor colliders together properly, so let's increase the collider's size briefly to overlap a little bit. Now the composite collider is perfect and we have one whole piece of a collider. Let's play the game and run into the walls like a madman. It's pretty awesome. It works as it should and our walls are modular, so we can build any kind of levels. Pretty cool. That's it for today, folks. Next time, we will draw a new character and its animations to improve our visuals. We will create a few variations of the archer and then animate the best one. In the end, we will import him into Unity as well. So be sure to subscribe and leave a thumbs up. If you have any questions about what you have just seen, feel free to ask and I try to answer all of them. See you next time!